She said, "As a child, I lived in the mountains. I used to collect fireflies in a jar and use the light to read my books. I said, what a beautiful world it is." She said, "Now, when I return to the mountains, there are no fireflies left." And I said, "What a heartbreaking world it is." So when our heroes grow old and our dreamers go mad, when our songbirds go silent and fires burn on each corner, I live for the little wins. When I hear footsteps in the hallway and I don't know whose they are, whether lover or torturer, ally or assassin, I live for the little wins. When there are hands on ears and tape over mouths, when I no longer know if I prefer to be awake or asleep, the silence of the undertow or the crashing of waves on a reef, when they promise us everything and treat us like nothing, I live for the little wins. Like when you eat a meal and straight afterwards you realize that what you just ate was exactly what you felt like. Like when you find out mangoes are $9 a box. Like when you get a surprise email and it makes your day. Like the first sip of water after a day-long fast, the first line after writer's block. Like when a student who can barely spell her name pens the perfect line. I live for the things I'm ready to die for. I stand for the things for which I'm ready to fall. We all promise that to ourselves sometimes. We, the people, most fragile of all. We, the people who drag nets to the shore hoping to find diamond rings in the guts of fish and pearls in the bellies of dragons. We, the men and women who stand in front of screens that scream at us to lose weight or gain funds. We, the seething mass of darlings and friends, rapists, racists, killers of men, romper stompers, heroes, fashionistas and feminists, protesters who swing their bats at the system hoping the shards fall into mosaics, and lovers who swing for the fences. This poem is for the survivors. It's for the outcasts. It's for the eccentrics who never let coolness whitewash their madness. This is for the kids on the mish, the kids on the pavements, in the basements, in the flats, and in the schoolyards. They will treat your voice like a crime for which you have no alibi. So make it a crime of passion. Raise it at their eyes, shoplift time, pickpocket perseverance from the haters and leave the rest behind. Speak with purpose, teeth brighter than a city's spine. Little win though it may be, who knows? Maybe someday, one day, the fireflies will return.